All right, this is the Big India Today exclusive. We are tracking closely. Breakthrough coming in on the Gauri Lankesh murder case. India Today, the only channel to have the pictures of Gauri Lankesh's killer. The special investigative team has released sketches, packed the photograph of the killer, which has been retrieved from the CCTV image, is with India Today. Now, this picture on your television screen clearly shows the facial features, structure, and a close-up of the killer near Gauri's house. The photograph has been developed with technical expertise. They have cleaned up the image completely and say it's very close in terms of the facial structure and the feature of the actual killer of Gauri Lankesh. This picture and the sketches have now been worked upon. The SIT have worked on the CCTV footage, enhanced every frame in the video to get this clear picture. Rohini Swami is joining me for more details on this India Today exclusive. You know, Rohini, till now we had sketches, but now a clear picture which details the facial features, the structure of the possible murderer of Gauri Lankesh.
Well, there's been a lot of work that has happened, especially when it comes to getting this particular photograph. And this is crucial evidence for the investigation on Gauri Lankesh's murder. Now, there have been several hours of CCTV footage. There have been several CCTV cameras that have been scrubbed through. And with the help of the various images from various angles, and 9 seconds of which the police also have released out to the media and the public to try and identify the killer, this particular photograph has also been enhanced and worked upon technologically to get a clear picture of the killer. It couldn't have got any more clearer than this. The facial features are very clear. As you can see, that this has been developed because after the photo, especially the video of the killer or the suspect, comes in through the side of Gauri's house, takes a look towards her house. At that time, the camera has clicked this, taken this video and has been recorded in the CD and in the DVR. Now, why is this important? This is also important because this is the first evidence that they're getting in terms of how the killer looks. Now, we know that they have released sketches. We know that they have released a CCTV footage of 9 seconds, but this one will help nail the killer himself. Now, they're not sure, as in the police are not sure whether the person belongs to an organization or whether it's an individual, but they're looking at various angles at this. But the police are hoping with this, they'll be able to crack the case sooner.
All right, Rohini Swami is with us, and what we have right now in possession of India Today is an exclusive picture of possibly the murderer of Gauri Lankesh. Now, sketches have been released in the past by the SIT, the Special Investigative Team. And the latest right now is that from the CCTV images that were released earlier, now experts have tracked in, zoomed in, completely cleaned the picture and come out with this, what you have on your television screen. Solid proof evidence, pictorial evidence, which suggests that this could be the killer of Gauri Lankesh. Now, this is photographic evidence which is in possession with India Today. Till now, there were only sketches that were released. How close will this lead the SIT to the actual murderers of Gauri Lankesh is another story. But piecing together, all right, so piecing together, all this evidence could prove crucial in a breakthrough sooner than later. What we did earlier was we spoke to Kavita Lankesh, Gauri Lankesh's sister, asking her about this recent development and also if the family was content with the speed of investigations.
No, if we had known, the investigation would have been over. I don't think we know who's killed her, but at the same time, there's a lot of evidence and clues. So I hope they're doing a good job and trying to prove as fast as possible. I mean, I can't say content till the investigation is finally come to its conclusion, but they're doing a good job, actually. They're doing there's a lot of hard work. I mean, they're also doing an extensive investigation, the way it looks like. So, yeah, I hope they reach a conclusion fast, that's all I can say.
Well, let's get in more reactions. We have Brinda Edige. She's a human rights activist. She's on the phone line with me. Ms. Edige, another breakthrough coming in. Do you reckon one step closer to possibly finding Gauri's murderers?
Absolutely. Now that they have a real sketch of a person who had come there and they have found it from the camera, I do hope that they would be able to get the entire face and post it around. But on another sense, I'm asking myself, is it really possible to find this guy inside Karnataka, within Bangalore? or has this guy already left for somewhere else? But yes, it is a step closer. At least you have concrete facial recognition or whatever it may be called that is there. And so people might be on the lookout. People, the citizens can help to look out for this person. And I think the police have done a great job in getting this sketch out. But we do hope that they would be able to get the entire face so that the citizens will be able to help the police in trying to nab this guy, find this guy, give some kind of a clue. They might have seen him a couple of days ago, a couple of weeks ago, something like that.
Ms. Edige, there's been a fair bit of civic social activism at the back of Gauri's murder. Do you reckon somewhere down the line that the police is now doing its job? Is there faith back in the system?
Absolutely. The faith in the police system, I don't think has ever waned. It has always been there on and off when such incidents come up. Then for a small portion of the time, then the confidence, the trust in the police goes off. And several questions are coming up, saying that, is it really possible for the police not to be professional? Is it possible for the police to be careless? But when they come out with these incidents and instances where they are able to recover the face of the perpetrator, the murderer, the faith is reinstilled, the confidence is reinstilled, or the intensity, the degree of the confidence is also enhanced. And I'm sure it is continuing with this enhanced confidence and trust in the Bangalore City Police.
All right, appreciate you joining us, Ms. Edige. Now, we've been talking to people, and till now there was a fair bit of anger. We'd seen a fair bit of activism as well as protest as part of on why the police was going slow, possibly not doing its job well. But now, with a sketch and then followed by this photographic, documented photographic evidence that has been released, there seems to be the faith that is reinstilled back in the system and hope that Gauri's murderers would be found soon. Rohini Swami is still with us. She's got that picture out, which you see on your television screen. Rohini, there's been, like we were talking earlier, there's been a fair bit of activism, protests that have come at the back of Gauri's murder. Now, a lot of it directed towards the administration, towards the policing system in the state. There seems to be now a revival, hopefully, of a bit of faith if this evidence reads to any conclusion.
Well, it's but natural to actually face criticism, especially when there has been issues, or rather the investigation of Dr. M.M. Kalburgi, who was shot at point blank at his residence in North Karnataka, remains unsolved. The murder of Dabolkar and Pansare remain unsolved to a large extent, because only as of now they have not got the killer himself. But keeping that in mind, we should also give credit to the police who have been working, or rather the special investigative team who have been working day and night to try and get as much evidence and as much of work that can be done on the investigation. Now, what we also know is that they have taken evidences from the location where the murder has taken place. They have a lot of eyewitnesses details which they have put together. They have a lot of CCTV footage. Hours and hours of CCTV footage. One thing we should remember is that when it came to Gauri's murder, this is the only case where they actually have a lot of CCTV footage in their hand. Pansare, Dabolkar, Kalburgi, there was no such kind of evidence that they had. And that is why it helps in the SIT team to investigate this in a more aggressive manner. Now, for the police also, be the sketches, because it was done with the help of two visual artists, they're specialized visual artists, who, based on eyewitness accounts and the CCTV footages, which is corroborated with each other, that they release these sketches. It is not easy. It is not easy for the police to actually come to sketches and release it, because they cannot go wrong. They cannot make a mistake on this, because their investigation needs to go on the right track. One mistake will put them off track, and that is why they're treading extremely carefully. Now, looking at it from the department sense, yes, that not only does it reinstate the trust, but there's always been Bangalore police, and for that matter, the Karnataka police, has always been known for its policing skills. It has been one of the top. It has received a lot of awards for this policing. But keeping that in mind, the whole point and the focus right now is to try and nab the killer of Gauri Lankesh. the Karnataka government also, the chief minister I've been speaking to, the home minister I've been speaking to, they're also hopeful that they will be able to nab the killer soon. But right now they want to keep their cards close to their chest, and because they want to show an arrest in the end of the day, and as soon as they do that, they can at least rest they can rest and say that they have found the killer, and they know exactly, possibly, whether it would link to the murders of Kalburgi, Dabolkar and Pansari.
All right, you know, but there is, like we were talking earlier as well, Rohini, there is skepticism that is attached to this as well, the current speed of investigations, the scale of investigations. However, when we did speak to Gauri Lankesh's sister, she did say that, no, they are not content, but at least the police seems to be working hard. They are looking at clues and they are hoping that the police reaches a conclusion. But there's a contrarian point of view also. Let's listen in to Mr. Nayak, a social rights activist who spoke to us a short while ago.
Hey, these sketches are simply ridiculous. Now, owing to the fact, see, the first theory which was put forth, that some so-called suspects met the mother of Gauri Lankesh to know about her whereabouts. Now, this theory has been floated very recently, but there is only one eyewitness to this incident, that is the lady in the opposite apartment who came out after hearing the gunshot, wherein she says that their faces were covered with helmets. Now, from where have these sketches emerged? You see, one particular sketch matches with an activist of a particular organization. Well, I don't feel that this is fair to target any individual. Now, from my question is, I am not against them drawing sketches, but I am questioning the very rational and the veracity of these sketches when nobody at all has seen these assailants. I do not know how these sketches are coming out based on a new theory that these so-called assailants had met the mother of Gauri Lankesh a few days ago to know about, sketch out her whereabouts.
All right, let's get in more reactions. We have Pramila Nisargi on the phone line with us. Ms. Nisargi, do you reckon now that there is documented photographic evidence giving out the basic facial features of possibly the murderer of Gauri Lankesh, we're one step closer to reaching a conclusive end to this investigation?
The question is, you know, I somehow feel they're diverting the attention of the public. They are not coming out to the truth. They want to divert it. Maybe the persons who are involved in this are someone different. These photographs may be the same person, may not be the same person. But they are not able to identify the person's name, nor their whereabouts. What's the use of having a photograph? In fact, they're seeking the help of the public to identify the person. That has not been done. Whatever may be, I do not like to comment about the investigation. They are doing their little job. It may be the photo with the cover or without the cover. And ultimately, what we want is the justice for Gauri Lankesh. They must catch the culprit, and then ultimately they must put them behind the bars. Only then we'll be satisfied. See, real investigation, if they are doing real investigation, they will not reveal about this thing to the public, because that will divert the attention and the investigation will not be proper. I do not know why. First some photographs, some other photographs, some now they are coming out with. I can't really understand their idea. Whatever it may be, ultimately, if the end result is to get the justice, and if the end result is to catch the culprit, I'd be extremely happy, and all people who are involved in this, who are concerned with Gauri Lankesh welfare, will be interested. Somehow I feel that something muddy investigation. People of their own family, that mother, the brothers, they had the litigation. Umpteen litigations were there in the courts. There are not one or two. Umpteen litigations were there for defamation. Ultimately, they must find out who the real culprit is.
All right,
appreciate
you joining us, Ms. Nisargi. We're going to closely keep an eye on the developments there on that story. But this is an India Today exclusive. Photographic evidence now, which has come forward. This particular picture that has been worked on by the SIT, giving out the facial features and structures of the possible murderer of Gauri Lankesh. Rohini Swami got us this exclusive. Thank you, Rohini, for joining us.